you are more than likely using some form of a technology provider within your current systems that we power. Our data is powering some of the tools that you're already using. You just don't know it. And that's how extensive the technology is. What we're predicting that's coming for the rest of this year, first half of 2021, is an incredible influx of used vehicle inventory. And we expect that to last well into the first half of 2021. It's going to be a tremendous opportunity for you guys in the industry that are driving and hauling these vehicles to take advantage of that. So to make the case for repo and haulers, I'm going to invite Alex to talk about the economic conditions in micro and macroeconomic.
Yeah, we're looking at macro factors, and here we on this slide, unemployment just skyrocketed when the economy closed. Here we're just looking at unemployment numbers. Economy is improving, but not fast enough. And what we see here is consumer confidence. This is, we're looking at delinquencies. Many lenders, and I believe most of the captives, they put consumers in hardship status. So it doesn't go on your credit score. It allows you to skip some payments.
We have been discussing a certain price point, a particular type of used vehicle that will be pure gold in the coming market. And that is that sub $10,000 price range vehicle, 6 years or older, that's in great condition. And we all know what the industry's like at auctions. That vehicle comes through the lane, it's commanding gold-like prices. Who's gonna help them get that vehicle to from point A to point B? And it may not be a full load. It's gonna be, as Ty had mentioned earlier, that onesie, twosie, or even three vehicles at a time. Or maybe you get sent to pick up a vehicle while you're there. You're getting to see at the customer's driveway because they have that under $10,000 vehicle that's 6 years or 6 years of age and older, in great shape. They just want to sell it to get some cash because they need it with the coming market. You're a driver. You're there picking up a vehicle delivered to a dealer. What if you had a hot list from your dealerships and you looked at it and said, this vehicle that the customer did not tell my dealer about is in this driveway. Mr. Customer, can I make an offer for your vehicle, that vehicle there too? Gas prices, good sign for car haulers. We anticipate that prices are going to maintain at the level they are for quite some time. So it's to your advantage that A, we have an influx of vehicles coming in use that need to be transported from A to Z, and B, get busy. Take advantage of all you can because you got gas prices at an all-time low. So coming into the next segment, I want to introduce you to Laura. Laura is our artist side of Black Book.
Thanks, Paul. So this is a look at our weekly wholesale price changes. And so we really started out the year, and I'm sure you saw in your own business that the market started off strong. Sales were going well early in the year at the auctions. Values were increasing early. I think as we move forward, the sales rates will increase as our values continue to decrease as we see remarketers adjusting their floors. And so more buyers and sellers are coming into equilibrium there with the price they're willing to pay and the price they're willing to accept. And we'll again continue to move a lot of cars for the remainder of the year as prices continue to fall. And so now as the market is settling back into a more normal behavior, they are starting to send some of those unwanted units back to auction. So great news, continued volume will be coming into the market. A lot of growth in like dealer to dealer channels and other direct to dealer sales. So still ways these vehicles still had to be moved. So all good things for you guys for over the summer and for the future. As remarketers are adjusting their floors, we're seeing that sale rate start to slowly come back. Everybody has a different strategy. Some of them are not adjusting floors yet. They're holding really firm. And so they're seeing some higher no sale rates right now. Others, you know, they are adjusting. We're hearing from remarketers that they've got more inventory on the horizon that's going to be coming back. And so they're having to adjust. So again, really good news for you guys. We've still got a lot of volume that's going to be coming into the market.
As Laura had mentioned, that many, many dealers have been reporting a shortage of used inventory in the wholesale marketplace. And we've been experiencing some incredibly smart dealers and dealer groups that have figured out ways to source inventory directly from their own backyard. Daily, we monitor between 14 to 15 million new car and independent websites. We tend to go straight to the dealership websites because that's where they list their inventory. They list all their inventory there. Even those vehicles that they never get to make it listed on AutoTrader or Cars.com, because when they put it on their website, it gets sold within a few days. So we monitor all the VDPs as well as the VIN number. We're looking for that VIN number that we haven't seen before. After you save it, goes in our data bank. Think about it this way. You gotta get the vehicles picked up and delivered. They gotta be remarketed some way, somehow. They gotta go through a reconditioning process. They have to get condition grade reports and inspections for resale. Someone needs to be able to capitalize on some process improvements that technology and data can improve and change and meet today's demand. When you take a look, that 15.3 million is what's anticipated in new car sales for 2021. That's not enough for the new car dealer market. They will figure out a way to sell more used vehicles. They just need your help to get their hands on them. Where are those cars coming from? We are anticipating that so far before the end of the year is over, we should see about 560,000 units that should be delivered into the auctions. Many times off these vehicles, the grounding dealer, as Laura mentioned earlier, tends to keep that vehicle. What if that's a customer who does not want to go to the dealership to turn in their vehicle? And the dealership, being short staffed, may not be able to pick it up. There is a resource, an opportunity, again, for transportation, logistics, to be able to fill that need and do it compliant, contactless, frictionless. And while you're in the process of doing it, how can you help the dealer find more available inventory? This is a topic here that's sensitive because we know a lot of people that might be in these positions. We have an unparalleled market today. It was instituted, it was mandated. It was not a failure of an economic system. What does that mean for, again, remarketing, storage and warehousing of those vehicles, collection services that are related to picking up those vehicles? And then as you pick those vehicles up, you got to think about the COVID-19 fear that's in the marketplace. The opportunity to turn this into an upside is incredible. Lenders are now started this process of restrictions on guidelines for financing. So that means that it's going to be more valuable to have the right year, model, make, and mileage combination at the right price to help a customer who's now considered a subprime customer. The person, the dealer who gets their hands on more of those vehicles will be able to meet the stricter credit requirements that are coming out to be able to get finance on those vehicles. Rental unit returns. How can we help the dealers get their hands on those vehicles quicker, faster, and easier? And also understand the actual trim level features and options that belong on that vehicle. At that point, that condition inspection, when you pick up the vehicle, is critical for you. When you deliver the vehicle, the delivery inspection, make sure the vehicle is equipped as it is and that the dealer gets it as they call it, is critical. If I'm correct, I know Manheim launched a condition report. They're upgrading it to meet the needs because dealers are requiring much more accurate condition reports. And there's probably one person that's more well suited to deliver that is the delivery driver, the final inspection that goes on the vehicle before it gets to the dealer. Alex and Laura put this slide together, and this is long-term projections on inventory. You'll notice that it goes out to 2024, and these are up to 8-year-old vehicles. The demand for those vehicles that are 6 years or older is just going to explode. And if you could see the dip in 2009 when the first depression happened, you see the dip when we started again with our shutdowns in 2020, down 7% versus over here, 8% over here for 2009. And the influx of that vehicle, because there's less leases, there's less new vehicles being sold, there's less rentals being put in the market, eventually the increase in inventory we have for the next year is going to start getting smaller and smaller. However, that inventory is sitting in people's driveways. You will find incredibly smart people that are in the market that will figure out a way to tap that resource If they're not going to the auctions, how can we get them? Carvana's doing it. Drive Time's doing it. CarMax is doing it. Vroom is doing it. Pedal is doing it. Get a Car is doing it. AutoNation is now doing it. They're planning to open up 100 locations within the next year. That is a market that will is totally dependent on the logistics of getting that vehicle from point A to point B and doing it in such a way that you might be the end all condition assessment signee.
I took down several notes, and we got a couple questions from the live chat. So I suppose the ball is in my court to figure out what to do next.